So you need to replace your brake cable. For whatever reason, it doesn't work. My reason, for example, is the threads on the actual thing are completely trashed, and so this nut right here barely turns, so it can't adjust the amount of grab that the rear brake has. So we're gonna replace it. So it's gonna be very hard for me to actually take this nut off. So what you guys can do is just take a bottle of lube or anything, give it a little spritz, just like that. You just take off your nut right here, all the way off. All right, just about there. Come on. About there. The threads are really screwed up at the very end. A little bit of... Come on. You know what? I have a better solution. You take your bolt cutters, put it right at the very end, and just snip it like so. So now you can disengage the rod from the actual brake itself, just like so. Just pull that back. Now this is flopping all back and forth. When you're taking this apart, you're gonna need certain parts. For example, obviously you need the brake. And secondly, you do need the spring for the new part. As you can see, this is the front of the brake rod. There is a cotter pin that you have to remove in order to take the front end of the brake rod off. So now you're just going to take out the cotter pin. You can use any set of pliers to do this. So now you've gotten the cotter pin out of the front of your rod. Set that aside because you're going to need that later. Now what you got to do is take the front of the rod off. There's a little pivot point right here. All you do is just pull that out and set that aside for later. There should also be a little tiny washer that comes with it too. Set this aside because you will need it. Now you can just take your rod all the way off. So now I'm going to show you the difference between an old brake rod and a new one. As you can see with this old one, that the front of the brake rod is actually very bent, and also the back of it's very bent and also cut off. I wonder why. So now holding it side by side, you can see that the back of them, this one's very bent and the threads are really black and dull and screwed up,
and this new one is perfectly fine. So now you take your new rod and your pivot and the washer and the cotter pin, put the rod right in like that, put in the pivot like so, put in the pivot so let that hang, put the washer on. Now you're gonna put your cotter pin in. So now you've gotten your cotter pin in. Now let's move to the rear. Now what you're gonna do is put the rear in to the back brake.
So you're gonna push forward so that the front lever goes down, pull the brake back. This might take some persuasion. Oh, there we go.
I just realized I completely stupid. I forgot
to put the spring onto the brake rod. So you put the spring on the rod,
and you push it forward, and the brake back.
Oh. All right, there we go. So now all you gotta do is just take your nut, your brand new nut, and just thread it on to your rod. Make sure you don't strip the threads.
So now you screwed on the nuts so much that your fingers pretty much fall off. You're pretty much gonna screw it on until your brake is how you want it. That's pretty much it. Thanks for watching, guys, and stay tuned till the next video.